الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. بإذن الله تعالى we will begin after Fajr reading from كتاب الرقاق للإمام البخاري رحمه الله. We know that البخاري in his صحيح divided it into books. The book of بدء الوحي, the book of the beginning of revelation, the book of knowledge, the book of salah, the book of zakah, the book of zakah, the book of hajj, and one of the books is called kitab al-riqaq. What is the meaning of al-riqaq? Al-riqaq comes from al-riqqa, softness. You say al-waraqa raqiqa. That sheet is a raqiqa, is what? Soft. And subhanallah, there is one limb in your body that must have that attribute. And if you don't have it, then there is something wrong with you. What is the name of this limb? Al-qalb. Al-qalb must be what? Raqiq. So it's praiseworthy, أمر ممدوح يعني. لو كان في قلبك رقة. If in your heart there is what? Softness. But it's blameworthy if you have رقة in the outer body. يعني the physical body, you must have what? Muscle, strong. So imagine our job is to make sure that we have what? Strong muscles, but at the same time you make sure that you have what? Soft heart. And this is why sometimes you find somebody with a very strong build, very strong, and he breaks in front of the Quran, cries, because his heart is what? Raqiq. So al-riqaq is the plural of this. And Imam al-Bukhari, in a way, he went or he simply tried to make himself unique in naming this chapter, this book, in such a manner. Because all the rest of the scholars who compiled hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they always would call this kitab كتاب الزهد. Always الزهد. الزهد. Because الزهد is what helps the heart to be what? رقيق. In any rate, in this chapter you will find out that الإمام البخاري compiled a lot of hadith that causes your heart to be what? Soft. So this is the purpose behind this book. So inshallah, every morning after Fajr, if we are here, whether here in Masjid al-Tawheed, Dar al-Tawheed, inshallah, we will try to read a hadith and just explain it. But in general, you know, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said in hadith النعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنهما, which is the beginning of it, الحلال بين والحرام بين. So at the beginning of the hadith, the halal is crystal clear, the haram is what? Crystal clear. And between them there is what? وبينهما أمور مشتبهات. Things that are what? We call it the gray area. And then at the end of the hadith, صلى الله عليه وسلم says what? ألا إن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلح صلح سائر الجسد وإذا فسد فسد سائر الجسد. Indeed, in your body there is a limb. If it is sound, pure, the rest of the body will be sound and pure and pure. And if it is corrupt, the rest of the body will be corrupt. Now, the question that I really want to ask you, what is the relationship between the beginning of the hadith and the end of the hadith? Why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you actually read, this is one hadith, you feel like there are two pieces here. First of all, he said, al-halal ubayyin. Halal is what? Crystal clear. Haram is what? Crystal clear. And then in between them, there is what? A gray area. Now a sign of righteousness and piety that you leave the gray and you be what? Towards what? Yani you leave the gray, even though you could be in the gray area as long as you do not step into the haram. But to al-wara, righteousness and piety that you leave what? Like Umar, when Umar said, تَرَكْنَا تِسْعَ أَعْشَارِ الْحَلَالِ, we avoided 9/10 of the halal to avoid 1 dirham, 1/10 of riba, of usury. The hala taqwa, wara, that you go into the halal side. And then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes that statement, أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَى. Indeed, in your body there is a limb. Now I'm asking you to reflect upon this. What is the relationship between the two statements? What? The first step to have sound heart is to eat halal. You see the connection here? When you go and that you leave also the area of what? Try to avoid the gray even. That will give you what? The soundness of this heart. فالقلب لأن المدار the our success, يعني your happiness in this life is really having a living heart. That when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's where you get the happiness. That's why we recite the Quran. That's why we sit in a gathering like this. Because you end up with that what? Softness of the heart. And that's what makes things easy. It helps you to handle your calamities, your tests. Huh? But when the heart is hard, you're fighting, you know, and في مصر يقول لك دبان وشك. You know, the flies over, you know, you're fighting everybody, getting upset with everybody. Huh? When your heart is what? But when your heart is soft, you're relaxed. And for your happiness, and this is what our scholars, our righteous predecessors, they said that, أَلَا إِنَّ Ibn Taymiyyah actually made that statement, فِي الدُّنْيَا لَجَنَّةِ. Indeed, in this dunya, there is jannah. If you do not enter it, you're not going to enter the jannah in akhirah. Now, how do you enter the jannah in the dunya? By working in that heart to be soft, by making sure that the heart is soft, by always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And your success in the hereafter is based on what? On your heart too. شوف هذه. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Your children, your wealth will not help you. The only thing which will help you that you bring with you in the day of resurrection, what? Really, if you literally translate this, that you bring with you, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ, that you أَتَى, يعني you come to Allah, be قَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, that you carry what? Ya Rab, a sound heart, good heart. If you want to go home with something today, because we haven't even started the hadith, and I really want to restrict this to just 15 minutes, inshallah, so that you don't run away from me. Ibn al-Qayyim made a statement, and this is something that you should memorize. لا يسلم القلب إلا إذا سلم من خمس وأتى بخمس. Your heart will never be sound unless it is protected from five. And to protect the heart from five, you must end up doing five. You see, you need to understand this. If you don't engage in obedience, you will be engaging in what? That's the nature of things. يا أيها الناس humankind, اعبدوا ربكم. Keep busy worshiping your Lord. الذي خلقكم, who created you, والذين من قبلكم, and those before you. Look at this. لعلكم تتقون. So that you may what? تتقون here means what? So that you may protect yourselves from disbelief, from hypocrisy. If you don't worship Allah, you're going to end up what? Disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For remember those five. يسلم القلب من شرك يناقض التوحيد. That your heart must be protected from shirk which opposes what? توحيد. So the first thing is توحيد. لا إله إلا الله. If you're engaging in shirk, your heart is going to be what? Mussalim. If you go to sorcerer and you believe the jinn and you believe that thing, your heart is going to be corrupt. You're not going to... The success of the heart is the success of the body. If your heart has tawheed, يا أخي أنا اعتمادي على الله. My reliance is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do whatever you... You go ahead and plot as much as you want to plot to harm me. أنا أعتمد على الله لا إله إلا الله ما هو ده التوحيد. But if I'm going to end up scared from this, scared from this, scared from this, لا. So what is the first one? شرك يناقض التوحيد. Two. Pay attention to this. بدعة تناقض السنة. Which is what? محمد رسول الله. That you must come up with what? Muhammad Rasulullah. That you stay away from innovation which will oppose what? Because any innovation opposes what? I think Ibn Mas'ud or one of them said this. Any time that you come with an innovation, it takes over or removes the sunnah. You come up with a practice, you find out it removes the sunnah. Those are what? Two. Three. هوى يناقض الإخلاص. هوى يناقض الإخلاص. That you do something for, you know, worldly things to gaining the acceptance of people, which will oppose what? Because when you do something, you must do it what? Sincerely. So those are what? Three. Two. شهوة تناقض الأمر. That you desire something so bad, it will make you oppose the command of Allah. Someone who likes to be high, he's going to find a way to legalize drugs for himself. He's going to convince himself it's halal, even though the command is there. Someone who loves money so much, it's okay if you earn it from lawful means, but that love of the money, if your heart is consumed with it, will drive you to earn it from unlawful means.
because there is Amr.
Someone who falls into the fitna of women, of course he can go and marry. There's nothing wrong with that. Huh? But if it's so consuming to your body, to your, heart, and you have no control over it, huh? It will make you oppose what? The command that you go and commit adultery and justify this. So those are what? So what was one? شرك يناقض التوحيد. Two. بدعة تناقض السنة. Three. هوى يناقض الإخلاص. That you do things to please people. I'm sitting here to please you. Or you do it for the dunya. Mainly the dunya. I'm doing here because I am going to collect from you. Dunya. Maslaha. That takes away الإخلاص. That you don't do it for who? Four. When you have shahwa. So you're craving so much for something, and the love of it occupies your body, your limb, your heart, consumes your heart. This will make you oppose the command of Allah. When you hear a command, don't do this, you're not going to say no to it. Number five, and the last one, غفلة يناقض الذكر, heedlessness, which opposes what? The remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because our religion legislated for us a lot of remembrance. You enter the masjid, you say dhikr. Allahumma aftah li abwaaba rahmatik. When you exit the masjid, you say dhikr. Allahumma inni as'aluka min fadlik. You get on the car, you say dhikr. Subhana alladhi sakhara lana hadha. When you're passing by and you see a car rack, you say alhamdulillah alladhi afani. مما ابتلى به هذا وفضلنا على كثير ممن خلق تفضيلا. When you see something nice, سبحان الله. When you go up, الله أكبر. When you go down, سبحان الله. When you enter the house, بسم الله ولجنا وتقول بسم الله. When you exit the house, بسم الله توكلنا على الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. When you go to sleep, there is dhikr. When you wake up from sleep, there is what? Dhikr. When you eat, there is what? Dhikr. When you finish eating, there is what? Dhikr. When you go to the bathroom, there is what? Dhikr. When you exit the bathroom, there is what? Dhikr. When you wear clothes, there is what? Dhikr. So if you actually engage in that dhikr all the time, that will keep the heart what? Alive. Always. These are the five. If you want to have a sound heart, I'm just going to read this hadith so that we actually did something today, because all of this was just unplanned. You know, that's the issue with these unplanned things. You sit here and you just Allahu Akbar. Okay. Normally, Imam al-Bukhari, he would call kitab. So this is the book of what? The book of what? What is the name of the book? Ar-Riqaq. The book of what? Ar-Riqaq. In English, softening of the hearts. And then he would break his book into chapters. Chapter 1. Like any other book that he did. Chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. So we're coming into what? Chapter 1 now. Normally, here is the work of Imam al-Bukhari for information. Is he gives a title to that chapter, which the scholars call it what? Tarjama. He just make a statement. And under that statement, he compiles the hadith, which what? Serves the title. So he given that chapter a title. And under that chapter, he looks for a Quran, looks for a hadith, a statement of a companion that does what? That explains the title. So what is the first chapter? He called it what? Babu as-sihhati wal-faraag wala aisha illa aishu al-akhirah. شايف الكلام؟ شايف هذا؟ Look at the two hadith which he compiled just to show you how he does it. First of all, this is in English. He called it what? Chapter 1, health and free time for doing good deeds. And then he said, there is no life worth living except the life in the hereafter. The first hadith is going to explain the first piece, as-sihha wal-faraq. And the second hadith will explain the second piece. Here is the first hadith. أخبرنا المكي ابن إبراهيم. We call this the chain, يا إخوة. يبقى الإمام البخاري, for him to say the hadith, he must have what? Heard it. And his sheikh heard it from another ear. And the chain must end up to who? The chain. We call it the chain of transmitters. هو الحديث is not like that. البخاري doesn't sit and say قال رسول الله. لا لا لا. He must have what? Chain. His sheikh is المكي ابن إبراهيم. المكي ابن إبراهيم says أخبرنا عبد الله ابن سعيد. المكي ابن إبراهيم heard the hadith from who? عبد الله ابن سعيد. عن أبي. عبد الله ابن سعيد heard it from who? From his father. Who heard it from who? عن ابن عباس. So شو look, ابن عباس الصحابي ولا لا؟ يبقى ابن عباس was there. ابن عباس said قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, نعمتان مغبون فيهما كثير من الناس, الصحة والفراغ. There are two bounties. A lot of people are losers once it comes to them, health and free time. And we're going to explain this, inshallah, next. The next hadith, quickly, so we can go, which explains what? Remember, Imam al-Bukhari called the chapter what? باب الصحة والفراغ, chapter of health and free time. So this hadith explained it, that a lot of people are losers once it comes to those two bounties. Now, and then he said, لا عيش إلا عيش الآخرة. He compiled the second hadith. He said, حدثنا محمد بن بشار قال حدثنا غندر حدثنا شعبة عن معاوية بن قرة عن أنس عن النبي قال اللهم لا عيش إلا عيش الآخرة فأصلح الأنصار والمهاجرة. Oh Allah, there is no life worth living but the life of al-akhirah. فَأَصْلِحْ, this is a wording. فَغْفِرْ, there is another wording. Forgive الأنصار والمهاجرين. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions used to chant this while they were doing what? Building the masjid in Medina. So they used to carry the rocks and say, اللهم لا عيش إلا عيش. شوف الدماغ, يعني just to show you how they were living the, you know, اللهم لا عيش إلا عيش الآخرة فاغفر للأنصار. Imagine carrying the rocks and it. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم actually used to carry the rock himself. He used to go and carry. No life worth living but the life of what? Imagine they are building a masjid, and whoever builds a masjid here, then they are preparing the house where, that's why they are really living the moment here, inshallah. So with this, inshallah, this is number one, inshallah. We're going to go back to those two hadith and explain them and give them more time, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والحمد لله رب العالمين.